Check out Richie from Boston's channel.
So check this out. This video is important, and it's especially if you live in the Southeast. But I think it's going to get worse than just the Southeast. But pay attention to this. You remember this? I did a video on this like 5 years ago about the DARPA mosquito for complex jobs like disaster relief and hazardous inspection. Oh my goodness, there's been a disaster. Quickly, let's send out a robotic mosquito that has a camera and an enormous syringe, because that will help during a disaster or hazardous inspection. The reason I'm showing you this is it's from January, February, March. So March is the third month. It was published on the 6th, so there's 3-6. That's perfect. And then 6-6-6. Perfect, right? You gotta love it. They never miss a chance. And in case you did miss it, check this. Notice the picture that Military Aerospace Electronics decided to use. Notice the picture. Notice anything strange there? Nothing to see here, folks. It's just a scientist holding up a tiny robot, right?
Columbia.
Nothing to see here, folks. Yeah. So, bear in mind that I did a video on these 5 years ago, which means these were completed 10 years ago. And back on the third month and the sixth day, they decided to run a story on it to remind you that they had these just a year ago. Okay? Let me turn your attention to this right here. This is from MIT, and I did a video on this a long time ago because I love this stuff. And notice the days that it was published. 9/11. It's just odd, isn't it? 3-6, and then 3-6. They never miss it. It's always there. At any rate, back in 2009, these guys were explaining how they could literally take a living organism and put a small computer chip on it and control it entirely. Beetles and other flying insects are masters of flight control, integrating sensory feedback from a visual sensors and to navigate and blah, blah, blah. Long story short, they figured out how to hack into a live insect. Why am I showing you this and this? Because of this. Again, now, I've already run a story on this or a video on this, but pay attention. Pay attention because it's going to get worse, and it's more of the externalization of the hierarchy. They're showing us what they're doing. Three quarters of a billion mosquitoes, genetically modified mosquitoes, are going to be released in Florida. And like this article says right here, what could go wrong with 750 million genetically modified mosquitoes? That's a lot. That's a large amount. And if you're unaware who's behind these mosquitoes, hold on to your hats. You're gonna be shocked. Yeah, it's him again. It's Bill Gates all over again. I just did a video about this the other day. But again, like Spiro says, just in case 2020 wasn't crazy enough, the EPA recently announced rolled back regulations for companies due to the coronavirus outbreak, paving the ways for companies to skirt environmental laws. So, thanks to the coronavirus outbreak, the EPA rolled back regulations. So, the 35 million people that lost their jobs, the rolled back regulations didn't help them. For the people that couldn't pay their rent or their mortgages, the rolled back regulations didn't help them. For the companies, the mom and pop stores, the restaurants, the bars, the hair cutters, the nail ladies, all those people that the rolled back regulations didn't help, guess who they did help? They helped Bill Gates. So what did he do with that help? Well, he's releasing three quarters of a billion genetically modified mosquitoes. Or are they?
Yay.
Because who knows? You'd never know what they are. And the fact that years ago, these guys could already take a microchip. That chip is enormous. This is 10 years later. They could put a chip on a mosquito that could probably make them fly it just like a drone and probably give them the ability to see what the mosquito's seeing. Don't laugh, because the drones that are available now are insane. But at any rate, so thanks to the coronavirus outbreak, which is him, the EPA made it easier for him to do things like this. So that's exactly what he did. But here's where it gets really, 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 really strange. I want to show you something. Right where they're going to release these mosquitoes, or where they've already been releasing them, because they usually tell us stuff after they already do it, this is happening. Two hurricanes, not just one, two hurricanes in the same exact area. Now, wouldn't that be strange if this hurricane showed up at the same time that all of these were released? I mean, that seems like something someone would have warned us about, right?
You guys know what this represents?
What? Tell us, sir.
Maybe it's the calm before the storm.
What's the storm?
Could be the calm before the storm.
What storm?
We have the world's great military people in this room. I will tell you that. And we're going to have a great evening. Thank you all for coming.
What storm, Mr. President?
You'll find out.
Yeah.
Give us